I had eye surgery. I had open eye surgery on Tuesday.
Can't even tell.
I know you can't, right? It's weird. And then I had a checkup yesterday. And so they went and I did all the, you know, the eye tests. You know how they tell you, read the bottom line, right? Mm-hmm. And I did all these tests. And the guy goes, now, you know how, like, in my life, I always pick the thing that's broken, or I get everything I get in my life is always the, like, no matter what, if I pick a magazine to read it, the page is ripped that I want to get to.
So many times. It's astounding. It's almost science at this point.
Yeah. And the people who are in charge of it always say, we've never seen this happen before.
So yesterday I'm doing this. So I had the surgery. I'm doing the post-op checkup and they're doing all the tests on my eyes. And the guy goes, okay, I need you to read that. They have all the, you know, the A, B, C, whatever, right? All the big letters, and it gets smaller, smaller, smaller. There's numbers. And so, the guy goes, I want you to read the lowest line you can possibly read. Cover up your left eye and read with your right eye. So I go, okay. So I read. The guy goes, what? And I read the line. He goes, hold on a second. Read it again. And I read. He gets up and leaves. He comes back. Doctor comes back. Apparently, my eye is like bionic.
Hey, you upgraded the lens.
I upgraded the lens. They freaked out.
That's what it is.
They freaked out. They totally were freaking out that my eyes, that I don't have to wear glasses ever again.
What?
Yeah, I'm not wearing glasses right now.
Oh, really?
What?
Yeah, they were like going
nuts.
So
it was just that eye?
No, because there's one more thing they have to do with my left eye that they're going to do on Monday. It takes 10 seconds. So I go back Monday, and then they zap, they do whatever they're going to do, and then that's it. Like right now, I don't have, like, I'm living without glasses. So I said to the doctor, he goes, yeah, you never have to wear glasses again. I said, wait a second. I go, these glasses give me some sort of false security. I go, like, I wore these glasses and I feel like I can interview celebrities. Like, it's this weird. It's
right,
weird.
Like, you had to shift your life when you needed the glasses to get used to them, but now it's like they're a part of you.
Yes, it's weird. Like, I would get in the car and I would go to put my glasses on. I'm like, wait a minute, I don't need my glasses. So, like, it's really weird. But I really, for me, when I was interviewing celebrities, I had this thing where I put the glasses on. And it's weird. It's like I could ask anything. I could do anything.
I think when you put glasses on, you just feel smarter.
It's not that I feel smarter. I feel like I feel protected.
Oh, okay.
It's like a mask. Oh.
Yeah, it's like if I say something embarrassing, I don't care. You know how they say eyes are the windows to the soul? Mm-hmm. When you have the glasses on, sunglasses or something, it covers up that. There's like, I can do anything. So I said to the guy, and he goes, it's all right. Get clear lenses or put anything you want on there. He goes, people do it all the time.
Yeah, the fake lenses.
Fake ones.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I go, I know that. I've heard that, but like for fun, like for Halloween. He goes, no, people do it all the time.
Oh, yeah, like for fashion.
Yeah, but I wouldn't do it for fashion. I would do it for, celebrity's coming in. Hold on a minute. Put my lenses on.
It's an accessory.
You could still put like that blue lens on it so you're protected from computers from this point forward.
That's what I've seen a lot of.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, that's one
Joey
of the first reasons.
Joey has a couple pairs of those.
Yeah, that's what my main, in the very beginning, was to have that to read so I wouldn't hurt my eyes. But now, like, I can read everything. Look, I'm reading right now.
For reading and looking out while you're driving, all of it without your glasses is totally normal to you right now.
Well, you know how you go swimming sometimes when you're a kid and you'd open your eyes underwater? Mm-hmm. And after swimming for a while, when you get out, there's that kind of a haze.
Yeah.
I have that on my left eye, and that's what they're going to fix in 10 seconds. I've got to go get my eye yagged.
What?
It's called a YAG machine.
Excuse me?
I know. Yeah. So I stick my head in this machine, and it takes 10 seconds, and they YAG it.
YAG it.
It's a YAG. And once that's YAGed, then I'm good to go.
It's like they get it off. Like they YAG off. They YAG off your eye.
What?
Maybe you do.
Oh my God.
You and your friends. Me, I'm just going to get in the YAG machine. Dr. Petlin.